Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. This video is about PCB fiducials. So this is a video for PCB designers and for people which they want to understand how the PCB assembly is actually getting done. Okay, so why do we have fiducials? So when the boards are getting loaded on the machines in the manufacturing process, the machines, they need to know exactly where the board is. And you may wonder why this is not happening naturally. It kind of does and it doesn't. So when the board is getting loaded on the machine, there is a stopper which is against the edge of the board, and then the board is getting clamped. Now the edge of the board is not actually a very precise position, let's say, because this is getting, the edge of the board are getting milled by a milling machine which has 0.1 of a millimeter error. So you can't afford a 0.1 millimeter clamping error on the machine. So that's why those fiducials, they were invented. What are the fiducials? The fiducials are optical markers. They're optical markers which they have very low positional error against the rest of the PCB, against the copper. And why is that? Because they are getting etched in the same process, in the same stage when they manufacture the PCBs with the rest of the board. So etching errors, they are very small. They are like below a thousandth of an inch, so 25 microns. So the positional error between the fiducials and the rest, they are very small. So we would like to know exactly where the board is clamped on the machine. So how is this happening? The board is coming on the machine, it's getting stopped, getting clamped, and then there is a camera which is coming and is looking at those fiducials. Now the machine is expecting those fiducials to be at certain coordinates which are already loaded in the machine. But obviously they are not going to be there because of the clamping errors. So what the camera, what the vision system does is actually trying to determine the center of those fiducials and is comparing where the center should be. So if there is a positional error, it's making the correction based on those errors which they've been measured by the vision system. Okay, so what kind of errors you can have? Most of the errors are actually translational, so like XY errors. But they could be, you can have rotational errors. Why? Because the conveyors, they have a little bit of leeway, they have a little bit of, space between the edge of the board and the conveyor, so the board doesn't snag. So the board can actually be clamped a little bit depending how the conveyor is actually worn. It can be clamped slightly off, but let's assume it's fine and they are going to be compensated by the optical system. Now, the errors, the fiducials they are trying to resolve, they're actually XY errors. They are not vertical errors. Okay, now where the fiducials they should be? So they should be in the as far as we can from the features. Why? Because positional errors are actually higher here outside, on the outside of the board. Inner, in the middle of the board, the positional error, they're actually hard to read. Second, we would like to have them in asymmetrical position. So if we have, let's say we have three fiducials, then the optical system can determine if the board was inserted in the machine the right way around or the wrong way around, which can happen. So if you have three fiducials which are asymmetrical, or even four, but they're asymmetrically laid down, then we can determine if the board is the right way around or the wrong way around. Okay, so I'll just jump to the PCB design side of the video. So you see the first fiducial? You're getting recognized? Bang. The second and the third. So this is the machine. Now the machine knows exactly where that board is. Okay, now that we know what fiducials are, where do we want them? How do we put them? So we want fiducials in the corner of the board, right? So it's ideally you'd like to have have them in an asymmetrical way. So you have them, you can have three or you can have four, but asymmetrical. When I say asymmetrical, you don't want them exactly in the same sequence against the same distance against the edge of the board. Why? Because you have them in the same, exactly in the same way, symmetrical. If you put this board on the conveyor like this, or you put it this way, the machine, they will not complaint, they will just recognize the fiducial and go. But if you put only three fiducials, the moment you put it the wrong way around, it will not find them where they're supposed to be. So it's expecting to find one here, here, here. You put it the wrong way around, here is not going to be a fiducial. Okay, now, because let's say you're a small shop, or you're assembling PCBs. You can't control the design, so you get some designs from customers. So what do? You don't, if they don't have fiducials, because some of them, they are beginners, they don't even know about fiducials. So in that case, what you can do, you can add rails. Now, you can add rails regardless. The rails are getting added to the board. Well, what are the rails? There are some margins. They're getting added to the board, so the board is getting transported easy on the conveyors and from machine to machine and internally inside the machine. But in the same time, the rails are, they have another reason. If you have some designers, they may have parts very close to the edge of the board. And if this is the edge where it's getting on the conveyor or the pick and place machine, the placing very, very close to the clamping mechanism is dangerous. You may destroy nozzles, you may, you know, all sort of things can happen. So you need to add those rails. Usually we add them and we break them off after we manufacture board. Now, when you create panels, you have to add them because they don't... Oh, sometimes, yeah, actually, that's another reason why. Sometimes you put rails because the board is small and it's below the clamping... the minimum clamping distance, so you add a little bit of extra. But anyway, so let's coming back. So you have those fiducials and you add them nicely on the those breakable margins, right? So in that case, you control the fiducial. You know what the fiducial, you can put whatever fiducials you like, right, on those. Now let's go back here on the screen a little bit on the what a good fiducial should be. So first of all, you need to have a very good contrast area, which is this green circle, right? I'll just zoom a little bit here, right? So this green circle, and then this is going to be it's basically like a pad, exactly like a pad where an SMT part is going to land, but it's obviously you're not going to solder anything. You would like to have this area as flat as you can and as reflective, but not very reflective, and I'll tell you why. Very reflective surfaces, they create shadows. So a nice matte reflective surface like gold is actually very good. So gold finish is perfect for fiducial, it's ideal. You can have a hull, like a hot air leveling, which is not that great because it's not completely flat. I mean, when you have a hull surface, it can be bumpy, it could be, so reflectance is actually not constant. Now, you would like to have, this is something critical, you want to have some solder paste free, this gray area. And it needs to be consistent. A good ratio is 1:3. So if you have 1 millimeter for the fiducial, for the actual pad, you would like to have 3 millimeters for the mask-free area. Why mask-free? Because solder mask is very reflective, so it's very shiny. So this creates a matte, non-reflective surface, so this will look black on the black and white camera, and this will look lighter. So you will have very good contrast. Now, if you have like this one, this design, if you have floods, like this is a flooded top side of the board, you want to make sure that your copper flood doesn't get close to the fiducial, so this area, so you use the setting, depending on the CAD you use the settings in such a way that the copper flood doesn't get close to the actual fiducial. That's it. So if you're a designer, this video is actually for designers. Add fiducials, they don't hurt.